Alright, welcome to Counter Slam, where we discuss everything War Machine Hordes and the Iron Kingdoms.
What's up?
Hi. Happy holidays, everyone. It's been a pretty fun, interesting Thanksgiving. I know going out and visiting family and rushing back here to get to the show was it's fun. So
I worked the whole time.
Just getting everything set up and being like, done!
Started! 2 days in Cincinnati and then got home.
Well, hosting family was work.
Yeah.
I worked the whole time.
I worked the whole time.
Yeah. You got paid for it, at least.
That's true.
Yeah, one of the things you guys may notice, and maybe a little hard to see, in the front, you're like, what are those little specks on the front of their table? Those
sort of horrifying is what they are.
Those are actually the Shamblers, the Bokur and the Shamblers from Minions. Picked those up during War Machine Weekend, and I got them all painted. And after this, I'm going to actually do the model review for them. So look for that coming up here on Monday or Tuesday, having that finished. And so you guys get a chance to see what they look like and what they can do. They're pretty cool.
Have you got to play them yet?
I haven't got a chance to play them yet. Okay. I did see people play them at War Machine Weekend, though. People put them together. It's so funny because they were getting ready for the tournaments, and they're just sitting there with the glue. They're like putting in, and there's like 21 of them, so they're like, okay, and trying to put the Bokur together, and they're like, man, I got this tournament. I got to put them in together so I can play them.
The year I played in Hardcore, I was playing Mark 1, and I was playing a Doom Shaper troll list, and the whelps had just come out, and everything had to be painted and based. So it was like the night before, put whelps on bases, paint them, didn't have any basing stuff, so get to Gen Con the next morning, find basing stuff, base models 10 minutes before tournament.
That's funny. So, so Privateer Press had their holiday bundles, things like that. Did any of you guys pick any of those up or any?
No.
What'd you guys think of them, I guess?
Better than last year.
Yeah. Honestly, I took a look at the Cador one, and it was very close to what my first 25-point list with Cador was, so that was nice.
Last year, did they have the two casters in there?
That was the biggest change. Yeah. Last year, last year was battle boxes plus some stuff.
Yeah.
It's kind of how it is this year, kind of showcasing, I know it's the new Winter Guard starter thing that they do. The biggest difference is they added the 10th anniversary coin, and that second caster.
Oh, it was a pin, not a coin.
Oh, sorry, yeah, 10th anniversary
and dice.
And dice.
So.
Which I would like to have both of, but I'm not going to buy a bundle.
Do you want mine? I got some at Gen Con.
Cool.
Do you want them?
Sure.
I have two. There you go.
Sweet.
All right.
That's awesome.
See, bring the worlds together. We got a Kador player and a Signar player, and they're trading off. It's that time of year, right?
Tis the season. You're right. Instead, I'm just going to melt them down. Make Signar and Wreck markers out of it.
No,
we need one per game, so it's all good. Make a really big one.
Yeah, I was looking at the Legion one. It was interesting because they instead of the regular battle box with the two-player, they swapped out the Carnivian with a Ravagor. They added a Seraph and took out two Shredders.
Yeah, I was actually going to suggest... I've got a buddy who's looking at... He's getting into Cyrus, but he also wants a Horus faction, and he's crossed between Circle and Everblight. And I was like, actually, you should probably get that.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. Although, of course, it comes with a plastic kit, so you could build a different... beast if you wanted to, but I guess in looking at P. Lilith with the Seraph and with her feet, all those shots they get would be boosted, which would be pretty nice. So make it pretty good for caster assassination. Mm-hmm. So
I like the troll one also. The troll one was comes with the new guys, the warders, which I thought was an interesting choice. When they first announced they were going to be doing it, I was hoping for a Creel Warrior repackage. And by the way, here are these.
But If they did the holiday bundle versus the holiday bundle, the troll players would hate the Crix one. It comes with the blood witches and the hag.
Well,
oh wow!
It's we do have because I noticed on all the other ones they put their heavy infantry into a lot of them, so they're the 8-point hit points infantry. Mm-hmm. And Crix has those. It's the harpoon guys. So I was like, oh, maybe they'll put them in there. And I looked, no, it's the hag.
That's because you're the only Crix player that ever fields those things.
Privateer doesn't even want to sell those models that bad.
I played against Jason last week. I used filled those guys and they worked pretty well. And I even tweaked the list where I could add a second unit of them too. So
I mean,
tier armies.
Creel Warriors do need a repackage though. Those guys are insanely expensive.
Hey, going back to the warders,
don't even make them plastic necessarily. Just for the love of God, package them 10 in a box.
Yeah.
So you can actually get all 10 and not worry about, if I warded it offline, they
might
not have blisters.
Well, that's what they did with the Iron Fangs, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, if they can make Kev that cheap, they can make Banes and Creel Warriors cheaper.
Yeah.
Because there's some really good tier lists that want two or three units of those things, and you'd have to sell a kidney or something.
Or a child, whatever.
Or a troll army like I did to get my Cador stuff.
Second person I've known has sold out their troll blood army. Even I sold off my troll blood army.
And you bought it back.
I bought it back.
See, most people can't do that. They sell it on Barter Town, then they can't find the people again. They're like, oh, the email's gone. I don't know who I sold it to. I can't get it back. But you were saying about the warders?
I took them on. I played Jason. He used them one night, and those things just gave me a headache. Like, they don't die.
Ever.
And they don't die because of Tuft. They just don't die.
They get to arm 22.
They can get up to arm 21 if you get crazy and throw the Earthborn Animus on them. They can get to 23.
And guess what Jason did?
I mean, there's no reason. They're like shock troopers at that point.
Yeah,
right. And I got a second unit of them coming in. So.
Yeah, they're no doubt they're really good.
Your crazy miniature market experience that you had.
Yes.
Oh, I was going to say, the Discount Games Inc. had a holiday bundle for the Gators, because a lot of people were arguing on the, or mentioning on the forums that they didn't have a Gator or a Merc one. I don't know if they had the Merc one. I didn't check that, but I did see they
had
a Gator
one. Was there not a Merc one? There was a pig one, right?
I don't remember.
No.
I thought there was a pig one.
No. But the Gator one had, like, Rask, a Rassler, a Swamp Horror, a min unit of the Bog Trog Ambushers, and a full unit of the Gator Posse.
Yeah, last year they had a pig one. Because I almost picked it up just because it came with another unit of Ferrobrigands. Mm-hmm. And so I was like, for the Beasts and the Ferrobrigands, that's actually almost a good deal for me.
So, although I don't know if the Discount Game one has like the tokens and stuff. I don't know if they throw that in there or not. I didn't see. They might have, just because it seems like they were trying to kind of match what
Private Press was doing. I just happened to notice them. So.
So.
Well, if you come that far, buying a $10 package of tokens isn't that bad.
Yeah.
Realistically, buying anything in this game after you drop a couple hundred on the actual miniatures.
Yeah. Hey, we're better off than 40K players.
Yes, we are. I was looking at earlier, I was out at Game Preserve looking at a bunch of stuff, and I picked up a box of Signarn Rangers that they had there. And then I picked up a box of some new 40K unit that is a Space Marine thing. And it was like $80 for the Space Marine thing for three models, and it was like, you know, $45 for, you know, 10 metal models.
The discrepancy, overall, the discrepancy isn't that big.
Six metal models. Let's get that
six?
Straight.
Okay. Yeah.
But that is a situation where it's really big. But honestly, nowadays, like, you're looking, unless you're playing a very weird list in 40K, you honestly are probably spending about the same amount of money building like a 50-point army and like a 1500-point army.
Until you start buying books.
Which you don't need to.
Their books are way expensive.
Agreed.
For 40K to fantasy.
Yes.
Yeah.
They definitely know
you can
how to
spend as much money on just the books for your army and your the rule book that you buy a whole army almost.
Yeah, $80 rule books for a game just.
Yeah. But, yeah, I don't know. The warders, pain. A lot of the new models I've encountered lately. Yeah.
Yeah, like I said, when I was looking through the holiday bundles, I was shocked to see the warders too. I was like, oh wow, so those are new ones. So
they're a really good unit, and
they're all plastic, right?
Yep.
Yeah, the Legion, man, they really want you to play those war spears, man.
They
keep throwing them out.
I don't
think
I've ever seen war spears played ever.
The UA makes them awesome.
Yeah, they're you really have to take the UA.
Also,
kind of like skinwalkers.
Yeah.
I was looking through a buddy of mine's bag the other day. He plays Legion. And I saw a Legion unit I didn't know exists called Grotesque.
Yeah, the flying one.
The models actually look really cool. They look like these little crazy gargoyle things. I like the models, but
Epic Dagrosh's Tier Army lets you take like four units of
like,
them or something silly like that.
I've never seen them before.
They have a command of like five. And I'm not kidding.
You get 10 like, dudes that you have to pack within five inches of the leader. You can't avoid AoEs.
Definitely need a UA there.
Yeah.
Yes, definitely.
Or just privateer thing. Command saying, oh, sorry, that was supposed to be a seven. Our bad.
Yeah, it's something. I'm like, why? Like, I look at their stats. Yeah, and their stats aren't bad. Maybe the gang, they have all kinds of stuff. Like,
Doom Reavers are a command seven.
They have stuff that would be like good. And it's just like, you look at them like, they fly. They got. It's like, what a cool idea, right? They got.
They've got gang. They're speed 7. They fly.
Yeah.
They're like mat 6 without the gang, power 11. So like, when you get in there, you're like 8/13s or something like that.
Yeah, it's pretty good. But then it's just like, but you got a command 5. It's like, okay, well now half my units out of formation, so they're not gonna be attacking, and the other ones are just gonna stand there.
You can't even surround a colossal.
And next time they're gonna die
because of that 5/6 level.
It could be 6, but I for some reason
I'm pretty sure they're
5 in my
agree
head.
With you. I
so.
Think it's
I thought they were speed 5, command 6.
I thought they were fast.
I didn't think they were fast. Because another knock on them is they have flight. but they're also really slow.
Okay. I could have sworn they were really fast.
Point in fact, didn't know they existed until the other day. Like,
yeah, nobody runs them. Nobody. It's rare. I did play a guy who played them mm-hmm. at the Colossal, or the Gargantuan's release event. Mm-hmm. I took Gators because I knew nobody else would probably be playing Gators, so I mm-hmm. might be able to get the coin. Some guy brought Legion, and they were playing the two caster format, and he brought Ryas and Saren, and one of the units he brought were the Grotesques and the Legionnaires, which I hadn't had much experience playing either of those, it was pretty interesting playing them.
I mean, I think every army's probably got one of those. Like, I mean, I field guns every now and then when I've got like two extra points and already mm-hmm. have like my War Dog or whatever. If I've got Joe in the list, I'll drop a field gun in because mm-hmm. I can at least get that boosted.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm willing to say 60% of the time my opponent goes, "What's that? Is that a mortar? That looks weird." Mm-hmm. And I'm like, "No, it's not a mortar. That's the crappier artillery we got."
Yeah.
Well, I think artillery in general is not used very much.
It's the one artillery that didn't change in how artillery works. They just flat out changed the rule. It used to, damage exceeding armor was doubled.
Yeah.
So, like, it wasn't super great because mm-hmm. like, beyond the butcher, there was really no way to increase damage or whatever, but, like, it was solid. You could punch, like, chickens with it and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The Grotesque's command is 6, it's not 5. So they can get around a Colossal. Yeah.
So it went from fluff wise having an armor piercing, like, super shell to.
Speed 5.
Speed 5? All right.
You know, did lots of damage to it, critically knockdowns with its armor piercing super shell.
Mm. But they're fearless.
They are fearless.
They have gang flight, power strike 10.
Oh, such a low command. You better have fearless.
Yeah,
like.
I hope so. Because otherwise you're going to be fleeing a lot.
Yeah.
So, yeah. There are 6 points for a 10-man unit.
Or, actually, minimum units might be the way to play them.
Four
points for six dudes. That six command isn't going to be a big deal at that point.
FA2, yeah. No,
Cossites are awful.
Cossites are not awful in scenario play, all right? At the very least, you get a six-man unit for 4 points that comes on the board in a clutch situation and at least holds off a point for a turn.
I'll pay 6 points for 10 Winter Guard and just run them at you in the first turn.
So did any of you guys buy anything over the weekend, like take advantage of any, like Black Friday deals or anything?
As a group, us and a couple other people are jumping into Malifaux's got a really big Black Friday sale going, mm-hmm. like early release stuff. So as a group, we're getting in on that. Mm-hmm. But
I bought a lot.
I got some HeroClix stuff from GamesRev with crazy Black Friday sales.
Yeah. Well, I know that Jason and I both put in decent orders for
Jason
models.
Jason, I
feel ashamed.
So what did you buy?
Let me pull up the text.
So
what'd you buy and what'd you pay?
You had sent me that text, and I'm like.
Yeah, hold on.
I deserve something too. So I got on Miniature Market because it was Black Friday deal, and they had the Axers, and I had been talking about like Axer spam. They're like the best light war beast, arguably in the game, I think. Hmm. And so I got myself a second Axer, two Night Trolls, full unit of Nyss, Nyss Hunters,
Pendrake, Nyssa. Second unit of warders, second two night trolls, a second axer.
Yeah, yeah. About 120 is what I spent.
Yeah,
nice.
I got another. Since I've been playing the Mechanithralls, I've been kind of liking them. So I got another unit of Mechanithralls. I got two more Brute Thralls. So I got to get a third one. Cool stuff didn't have three. So a Stitch Thrall, you know, our Necrosurgeon Stitch Thralls. I got another Bloat Thrall. Two more units, I guess, of the Scrap Thralls, so I could field 9 on the field if I wanted to, so I got all of them.
How many Bloat Thralls are you going to play?
You can play 2. I only have one.
Do you guys remember when Bloat Thralls were in, like, every Krix list?
Well, yeah,
because
you could
they
throw them.
Auto-caused AoE.
Oh, yeah, you can still do that. You can still throw them.
Well, it used to be you could throw them, and they weren't knocked down, and then they could do something.
And mm-hmm. I played a guy who used them against me at War Machine Weekend, and they were cool. I was like, man, why
they don't
so long
they
to
don't
get them,
auto
right?
corrosion now, right?
No,
it's corrosion damage, but yeah. So it used to just be everything under the template got mm-hmm. corrosion. So that's why most people use them because they would just go bleh, and then in the old days
you could throw them and explode them.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they still die.
Yeah, they can be knocked down.
Die,
it's just, it was you'd have your death jack. You'd walk up and punch one with a Mechanithral to get some damage on it, and then your death jack would go brr.
Oh, I'm still going to be doing that.
Kind of like what you do with cleansers.
Cleansers,
you have your castigators,
awesome.
Just pass your cleansers out in front of people.
Mm-hmm. So yeah. I bought that. I think I spent like maybe 60, 70 bucks, I think, for all that.
Yeah, I went and, because I had a little bit of a Black Friday budget set aside. and it was debating on what it was going to go towards, like, what it was going to go towards. And the only stuff I really needed for Kador was, like, I was like, oh, maybe some Jack kits and the new Iron Fang Kovniks.
Mm.
And none of that was really on sale anywhere, so I was just like,
meh. I didn't do any Black Friday shopping, but I did end up getting Ragman earlier this week, and it's something I've kind of been thinking about for a while, and I just am really looking forward to having him and seeing how it works. Mine. I didn't know you had Ragman.
He's a decent solo. I mean, he's got some pretty cool effects, you know, with the giving things Dark Shroud all around him. And,
yeah.
You know, that's pretty.
But
he's got this.
He's slow.
Yeah, he's a little slow.
He won't go well in my playstyle. Eric actually likes to run Jax and, like.
Yeah. I like to run a little slower, whereas he likes to run really fast. So
he'll actually use the Ragman at some point. Yeah. My Ragman will be like, "But you're so far away."
he's one of those options. It's nice to have.
Yeah,
I mean, a lot of those Merc solos.
Yeah, I'm not gonna. Well, it's like I finally got Madeline Corbeau, not because I'm gonna use her all the time, but like, especially with Butcher 3 now, on the rare occasion that I am playing that, like, I'm just gonna get to you and you're screwed. List. Yeah. Like
Madeline's almost required for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's amazing for Tempest as well. So
totally not going to go in his tier army, but it would be really cool if his tier army could include her.
Yeah.
On the whole acquiring Ragman thing, though, I was kind of looking back through Wrath, and I realized I don't see a lot of the models from Wrath played very often.
It wasn't a very good book.
I think Eliminators I see a lot, and I see hardly anything from Signar. I've still yet to see either any of the Jacks from Signar.
Which is unfortunate, because
most of the Crick stuff
you
just don't see.
The two Jacks that Signar got are really good. The Quake Gun.
The Avenger
The Avenger. It's the Avenger
one.
And the Minuteman.
Yes.
And the Minuteman is the first Jack with jump jets that I'm aware of.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because he has Flak Field, so he's just like the Basher. Where at any point during his movement, he goes, okay, everybody within 2 inches of me, take a pile 12 or pile 10. I forget what it is.
I think it's 10s on
it. I think it's 10s. But it's just everybody within 2 inches takes it, and then he can spend a point of focus to jump 5 inches away, which is kind of like a light cap move.
Yeah.
So
and
he's got two slug guns.
And he does have two slug guns. They are short range. They're only 8 inches.
Mm-hmm.
They might be shorter than that.
They're four.
They're four inches. I'm sorry. Yeah. So, I mean, he has a lot of mobility. With Kray, he's going to be really obnoxious. Yeah. Because he's a light jack.
And like I was telling you, what Sam was doing for a while, he was marshaling an Avenger and a Minuteman with his gun mages in his epic Kane tier army. So he had two units of gun mages with the attachments, and he had an Avenger and Minuteman on each of them. And, I mean, he was wrecking
the
stuff
Avenger,
way better than I thought he was going
to. Avenger with, I mean, and it's, all you have to do is hit, and everybody in the temple is knocked down. And
it's a
big temple.
So he was snipe boosting the Avenger, knocking down a group of three or four dudes, and then having the Minuteman jump in and go.
That's how I lost in the first round of Slam with the Ram. I had my opponent. I was up on him 4 points, and all I had to do was stand there, and I would have won because he had nothing near me. I was playing Haley, and he got an Avenger close enough and just barely caught Haley in the thing, knocked her down, and he came
shot
through his own guys because he was using the Silver Line. But yeah, it was. He also hit me with Eris, which she like went through like 3 free strikes and didn't die. So
wow,
it was a very Goldbergian machine where he was like. Yeah.
I feel I'm gonna take blame for that. A long time ago, Scrappy took a free strike from a Swamp Gobber.
Yeah.
To get to somebody's caster.
Mm-hmm.
And lost his movement.
Oh,
that sucks.
I feel that was my need for good karma.
Was this in Mark 1?
Yeah.
Okay, because any more movement doesn't do anything. It drops your defense.
You stop charge.
Oh, it stops charging?
Yeah, any movement penalty stops charge. But this Eris model I tried to kill for 4 rounds, and she just, every time, she just slipped out of the... And finally, I had her pinned up against the side of the board, and she was able to go through 3 boom howlers...
Oh.
Get range on Haley and hit her and dropped all my focus. Because I knew it was coming, so I was like, oh, I'll just camp all my focus. So she was armor stupid.
Then she disrupts.
And then she disrupted and I lost and Kane hopped over the wall and killed me. Which, you know, good play on him.
Yeah.
I had him bottled up the whole game. I had the whole side of the table to myself.
I saw when the Minuteman came out, though, going back to that, I saw, like, people were really excited. I saw, like, spam lists. I'm going to field, like, 5 minutes.
Yeah.
And people tried it for a while.
The problem with that is you need all that focus to do his...
Well, yeah. What I noticed a lot of people, especially in the area that were playing, I'm like, 3 or 4 Signar players that got, like, 4 of them right away and were, like, jumping them without spending focus. And so, like, after I saw a dude do it 2 or 3 games, I was just like, you know you have to, like,
You have to spend focus, yeah.
Because I wasn't sure entirely.
So putting them on, like, a gun mage unit is, they can't jump if you do that. But they do benefit from the other benefits of being a gun mage.
Sniping, all that stuff, the just the extra attack from the Jack Marshall ability.
Well, I mean...
Him and the...
The new siege tier.
With all those journeymen.
With all the journeymen and minutemen.
The only problem with journeymen is they're not exactly resilient.
They arcane shield themselves.
That's true.
And then the rest of the game, they're just upkeeping arcane shield and giving two focus to their minuteman.
No, that might work. That's a crazy... That whole list
it's
is
skew,
nuts.
Joel.
It
skew.
Is skew. It is skew, and when the new character journeymen come out, I will probably play that list.
Character
journeymen. Under Siege's feet, they could really tear up things with those slugs.
Oh yeah, they're pretty decent.
Yeah.
So I don't understand why we don't see more Avengers.
Yes.
And I don't understand why we see more Minutemen. I personally
think it's the chassis they're on because they're slower, right? They're the Speed 4 chassis.
I think so.
They're an Ironclad chassis. Yeah. So they're
so they're not Centurion chassis. They're, okay,
no, they're Speed 5s. I'm pretty sure he's a speed.
I don't know. Yeah, if it's the Ironclad Jazzy, I don't know why we don't see him more than
that. It's the other heavy kit is where he comes out of.
The Centurion Hammersmith kit.
Yeah, it's the Centurion Hammersmith kit.
Yeah, he's speed 4. That's
As far as Minoth goes, I mean, I understand Thyra's not the best caster in the world.
I had a great win record against Horde. Anytime Horde's...
Yeah. Thyra hits but, like, the thing with them is they got the, what was it, the Sanctifier? Who is a pretty decent Jack and a soul machine, and I think I've seen his model once, but never actually gotten to play against it. And
when Reckoners cost 8 points.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's the Minoth mentality.
I mean, it's...
We have a Reckoner.
So with Kador, what we got? We got the Decimator and...
We got the Demolisher.
Demolisher.
Jose was telling me that in the Minoth forums, there's some kind of chart that somebody created where, like, they were looking at, like, all the Minoth players and lists they were taking and, like, which lists were taken. Like, the Reckoner was in, like, 96% of the list.
Yeah, surprise me.
It's a good Jack, especially when you throw a choir on it.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. But, you know, it's 96% of the list.
It's got
it.
I mean, it hits as hard as other Jacks, especially with the choir, and as well as other Jacks.
4% exists that doesn't have a Reckoner.
There are four people who, you know, just...
Yeah. There are some that you might not like. I honestly don't know if you actually want one in an Amon Duraza list.
Yeah.
But when was the last time I ever played that?
I would play him all the time.
Really?
Yeah.
I played him a lot.
The only time I ever played him was against Jason. Jason wrecked me.
If someone buys me an Amon list of my design, I will play it exclusively for a year. I won't touch my Kador. I will only play that list if someone buys it for me.
Challenge accepted.
The other thing about Wrath is I know the character jacks that are in there. Mm-hmm. I don't use mine.
Torch
and Black Ivan were in it. And here we go.
Black Ivan is... Torch is... I really liked Torch when I first saw him because I really liked Strakov's tier armor and everything like that. Then I started actually playing him and was just like, I should just use a Spriggan or a Decimator or something. You know, not that.
And we're not going to talk about my overpriced character, so...
Yeah. And everybody...
You mean your
Beasto
9 defender? Your 11-point defender? That's awesome.
Yeah, my 11-point defender.
Yeah, he's great.
Beasto
9's an 11-point juggernaut,
goes with
by the way.
My favorite caster.
Yeah.
That I just never... he's 11 points. I would never use
That's funny, because, you know, Beasto 9's 11 points compared to a juggernaut. Beasto and he goes with one of my favorite casters,
so
Epic
better.
Sorcia. It's really great. I think one of us got the better end of the deal.
Yeah, Triumph is not good. He's good. Let me rephrase that. He's good. He's 11 points.
He should be 10.
He should be 10.
I can't think of a single reason why he needed that extra point.
I don't know.
I think Death Jack should be 10 too.
No. You get focus.
The problem with Triumph is you won't ever use him because I could just put a defender in the list for 9. It does almost everything that the Triumph does.
Can't ignore stealth.
Yeah.
But you're going to be running Black 13th anyway, so if you really ignore stealth, you just drop a flare over there.
And he has to stay stationary to do that.
Yeah.
So, you know.
He's a terrible Jack.
Yeah, well,
except for next week.
We'll see what happens next week.
Speaking of that, next week we got our big, for those of you guys who want to watch, we're going to have a 7-player game, which I don't think has ever happened on the internets. All of our hosts are going to play. We get one caster and either one Jack or one Beast. So
Non-Colossals.
And we are all... bringing the big guns. It's going to be pretty ridiculous. So.
I'm really looking forward to it.
I think you're the only Hordes player. I think everybody else is doing because even Jeremy's doing Retribution. So,
told you.
And you're taking Cricks. Yeah,
I'm taking Cricks. So,
man,
I should just win on default.
I don't want to leave you blowing in the breeze there.
That's all right. You're going to hate me.
You
by
should
the
take
end of the
Arcadius
game.
And a Warhog. Oh my god, that's such a good idea.
Well, you have until next week to figure it out because I'm putting videos together now. So, so that's going to be our game next week. So definitely tune in for that and see which caster's left standing.
It should be
end.
A lot of fun.
So
Arcadius is a terrible idea. Once he loses the Warhog, he's screwed. He can't hurt things
or
that aren't living.
Or Midas.
I'm just going to play stay away from everybody.
My guy's
so.
Not going to be there anyway.
I'm going to play this is my corner, don't come
you
near me.
You can at least hurt things.
You're Krix, of course you are.
You have powerful strike, bro.
No, I don't know, we might make it like a King of the Hill format where you got to get to the hill and hold it.
Oh, come on.
It's not even a gun, it's a needle. Yeah, Arcadius is one weapon, which he is Mat 6 with, so I mean that's kind of impressive, but you know, it's his giant syringe that if you're not living, his drugs don't work on you.
Yeah. So
he'll walk up to, you know. I so can't even kill your caster. Maybe. Oh, no, you're playing Scar. I could kill you.
Yeah.
Over
the
course of like 5 turns.
Yeah.
Oh, God, you're playing Scar?
I thought about playing E-Scar.
Crap.
Or E-Gaspy or something.
This is going to take forever.
No, don't play E-Gaspy.
We only got 2 models.
Take forever. No,
yeah, but we're going to have like 3 turns where nobody gets to do anything. I'm just going to play Zergova. Everybody's going to lose.
Well, then that should be even faster. Okay. Turn 1. Turn 2.
Yeah, Zergova and Behemoth. That actually probably would be decent.
I'm at least taking a caster that, again, it just is all is offensive. It's not. There's nothing about there's no control there, so... I'm not playing either
in the corner.
I thought about playing Epic Vlad.
You're not doing that.
Because of what you're running. So the turn you pop your feet, I was going to play Epic Vlad and just spin as much focus as possible without killing myself and run away. So I can get +3 to all my stats. And then come back like 5 turns later after I heal myself.
Yeah. I'm just in the corner, heal.
I'm just going to play the...
One of the only abilities in this game I never see used ever.
Wow, healing...
Spending focus to heal yourself.
It's rare that it's useful.
I played against a Krix player who did that once. Sean was doing that.
Oh, yeah?
Times. Yeah, with Scar, because he'd cut her and was cutting her to, you know,
I
boost.
I didn't even
like
think
that.
About that until the other day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I've always seen it in Hordes. I've never seen anybody do it in War Machine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean...
If somebody did it, I'd probably be like, what are you doing?
Well, it's rare that it's useful.
Yeah. Well, because usually in War Machine, if you lose your caster, you lose them all in one go.
Yeah.
You don't get a chance to spend focus.
Yeah.
Or if you're spending your focus after you've taken a bunch of damage, you should generally then retaliate.
Yeah, it's
Epic Vlad is honestly one of the only casters I ever generally heal with, because he'll take 3 or 4 points of damage. I'll get 1, 2, 3 blood tokens or whatever. I'll go ahead and generally use those to heal myself.
Sure.
And just...
Because
they turn the focus. Yeah, he gets blood tokens whenever he takes damage.
It's not even that. I was thinking about his Blood of Kings or Might of Kings ability. Yeah. But that sticks with you for the rest of the game. So that,
If you get him down to 5 or less damage, he's +3 to all stats. If he can then somehow heal up to full,
he's still +3.
He's
+3
to all
stats.
Stats, full health.
Yeah.
Oh, the only time I've ever done that was when I got backlashed a bunch, and they were all single points of damage. So every point of damage I took, I got a focus that I could spend to heal myself.
You know, TJ, actually, I have a special surprise for you today too, and it comes with the meme of the week. The person we selected for meme of the week this week.
Oh.
Hey Chris, would you bring up meme of the week this week? So last week, TJ had made a comment about the guy who that wasn't the actual frame where he says that.
Do we know if he got my email? I responded.
He did. Yeah. So he found the frame, he remade it, and he resubmitted it. So I thought since he popped feed on TJ. He wins again this week too. So. Yeah.
I'm good with that.
Yeah,
we'll give you a full set of Counter Slam dice you can use for your army. We'll ship that out to you here this week. So, So anyway, we got.
What's he doing with his hand there?
What's he doing with his hand up there?
He's talking. Yeah, he was talking.
This
about
is a
the
gift
rings.
It looked like from the enemy with this power. Yeah, that's that's the moment.
I saw this.
Oh, and this one.
And this one, that was him.
Yeah,
one does not simply. The original meme was this.
Yeah.
So he got it right.
Yeah.
Booyah. Okay, so, all right, we got a game going on this week. We got Conrad.
We do. This is going to be...
Jason. In our first ever Counter-Slam grudge match, by the way. Woo-hoo! This is the first time the two players who have played each other in the past played, and it's on the same week with the same terrain, so it's like snowing. And we even put in the little animation effect, so it's actually snowing on the board, by the way, when you guys
it's
were playing.
It's kind of cold in here.
So, yeah.
And Conrad is playing an army I typically use.
Yeah.
So I'm going to do my best to keep my mouth shut.
So
again.
So can Conrad beat Jason with another TJ list?
I've always wanted to try this list. I just don't have the means to afford this list is the problem.
Yeah. So, all right.
Because this is the one time you can use this list. So,
are you guys ready to get this game on?
I'm ready to rock and roll.
Let's do it.